Hi, Mark. How are you?
Doing great. How are you?
I'm well. Excited to be talking to you today about a new record, too, right?
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. Did a new record and knocked it all out, produced it, played everything, just about everything on the thing, and just had a great time doing it.
Yeah, that's pretty impressive. I mean, playing everything on the record. When you're writing, that's all the pressure on you, though, right? Like, how quickly does
it is. Yeah. Well, the hardest part is to be objective. That is very well said, exactly. But you know how it is in radio on that side. You know, if you know what fits, you know what sounds good, you get to kind of, yeah that's good, or yeah, that's all right. You know, you can make pretty quick decisions. But being in a band is a lot different than when you're just doing it on your own.
Yeah, how quickly does the songs take to form in that way? Because if you've got to come up with all the parts, basically, you know, you're not jamming with anyone at this point.
No, but I write songs pretty quick. In fact, the Stick It To You record, which is my most famous record, was Dana and I wrote that in about 2.5 weeks. So, you know, really, it's more about the feel, the, you know, where the music's taking you, and you're just trying to, again, paint a soundtrack for people's lives, and certainly, that's one of the things that I did on this record. It's an old classic rock sound with some modern sensibility to it.
I was actually going to ask, because in the press release, it's, of course, got that old adage of a return to form. And I was wondering, like, is that how you see it, or is that just a press release favorite?
No, I think that's just how, but, you know, everybody's trying to box and put music in. This is what it is, and this is what it is. The bottom line is, it's a rock and roll record. It's a classic rock and roll record. If this was 25 years ago, it would have, you know, been just another phase of what I was doing. But the songs are there. The attitude is there. The difference between 20 years ago and now is I write about different things of what I would have written back then. I mean, I've matured as time goes on, and certainly I think that is reflected in the music.
Yeah, and there's so many different styles all over this record, which I think is one of the more fun things to be listening to. I've read about you trying to sequence it as an album, which, of course, is refreshing these days.
Well, yeah, it was a conscious effort. I mean, I really wanted it to play like a record, because the records that I always loved and still ring true to my heart are the ones that just kind of flow. And there was a few songs I pulled off, and they were good songs, but they didn't fit on this body of work. They'll wind up, you know, here or there on the next record or one down the line, you know.
There's one song I would point out, and it's only notable in this sense because of, you know, where you came out in rock history and the timing and all that, but Conspiracy, which, you know, it sort of has that grungy sound to it, you know, the Alice in Chains feel. And as I said, that's notable because that was as it's been written. You know, the Seattle bands are what took, you know, bands like Slaughter out of the spotlight for the time. And I think for me, it all goes to show that it really was just all one big rock and roll sound, that it was, again, the press that was making the thing about it. Because, I mean, even talking about those bands, Alice in Chains and even Soundgarden, I mean, they were birthed from the same metal scene that you came from, right?
Yeah, absolutely. And I was a big fan of Soundgarden, even more so than Alice in Chains. But you know, people have said that to me, and I didn't really even think of it as being, you know, the grunge thing or that. You know, I always looked at it as Black Sabbath. I mean,
right.
You know, I go back to what I grew up with, but, you know, there was a harmony that I put on the front of it instead of it just being one straight voice. As I put a harmony, because Conspiracy has like this off-center. It's not something that should sound exactly, you know, pure and sweet and major sounding. And I wanted that little bit of a diminished thing, and boom, that was what I did. And that's what made it feel, you know, adding that other voice in there, it did have a kind of an Alice in Chains thing to it. But, you know, I'll nod to those who do it. I mean, I'm not going to run from it. It's all good.
No, it's a cool song. I really do love it. I mean, it's complete compliments to many of the songs on this record. I'd kind of be curious how John Cranfield, you know, works with you, because, you know, looking at him, he's worked from everybody from AFI to Pink and Nick Jonas. And I was wondering, like, what's the middle ground in your conversations with a guy like that?
Well, what it is, he mixed it. You know, what he did is, you know, I did all the production, and I just, you know, he recorded the drums out in Los Angeles, he mixed it. He's an incredible, he's had incredible ears. And you know, again, it's from a different, you're right, it is from a totally different wheelhouse from where I am. But I think the combination of the two just made a really, really good sounding rock record.
And you used Tim Kelly's guitar on this record? Did I read that right too?
I did. It there's a gentleman named Rodney Hardison who had his guitar, knew it was one of Tim's guitars, and brought it to one of the shows. He messaged me through Facebook, and he brought the guitar down to the gig, and lo and behold, it ended up in my hands. And it's one of those things that is rock and roll history, to me at least, and it made its way into the record. So it's kind of like an old friend came back to join me for a bit. It was really nice.
Yeah, to have that sort of opportunity, that really does make it special. I love the whole thing. I love what you're doing here. And I know you're sort of playing double duties because Slaughter is still on tour, right?
Slaughter's still on tour. You know, my band's on tour with Vince Neil as well. So, we're all working. This is what we do. You know, again, it's nice to be part of the working class of keeping rock and roll alive. You know, certainly it's what I love, it's what I do, and it's what I dreamed of as a young kid, and I'm still doing it this many years later.
We're all glad you're still doing it. Thanks for the new record and the talk today.
Hey, I appreciate it. Thank you so much.
All right. Take care, Mark.
Thank you.
Bye.
Have a great day.